The Queen looked radiant as she greeted volunteers at Windsor Castle on Tuesday night. Her Majesty was hosting a reception to mark the centenary of the National Council for Voluntary Organizations, NCVO, which was attended by several charity volunteers as well as her daughter the Princess Royal. The Queen, 92, wore a light blue skirt with a matching jacket as she made her way through the attendees. NCVO, of which the Queen is a patron, represents a third of the voluntary sector workforce in England, with 14,000 member organizations. The reception celebrated the last 100 years of voluntary work as well as its contribution to the UK's history. During the reception, Ron Knight, 88, and Louise Monroe, 24, two volunteers for different organizations, were introduced to the Queen. She matched Carl Ludwig dress and jacket in aqua blue with a Cullen and diamond drop brooch with a string of delicate pearls, small pearl earrings and also a black handbag and gloves. While her daughter, the Princess Royal, wore a smart red suit, also with pearls as she met the volunteers. The reception brought together members of the UK's charity sector and volunteers of all ages. Charities spread across a wide range of causes, from the environment to social and economic issues. Among the organizations represented at the reception was Leap Confronting Conflict, based in Finsbury Park, North London, which provides workshops in managing conflict for young people who are involved in gangs or excluded from schools. Trustee Chantal Chang, who spoke to the Queen about her role, told the press association, "With gang violence on the rise at the moment, I think it's prime time for the Queen to be involved in something like this. We have so many young kids dying on the streets, so her being a part of this movement is vital." The Queen also shook hands with NCVO Chairman Peter Kellner and Chief Executive Sir Stuart Hetherington in St George's Hall. Other guests were welcomed in the Grand Reception Room by the Queen. The Princess Royal and the Duke and Duchess of Gloucester also chatted with reception guests. The Queen patrons 600 charities herself and supports two awards, created to recognize the work of volunteers, the Queen's Award for Voluntary Service and the Commonwealth Points of Light Award. Sir Stuart said, "The royal family have been our patron for 100 years and that's very important to us. We represent charities in Britain and the Queen has always been involved in charitable activity. This endorsement is massive for us and very important, it's a wonderful thing she's done." He added, "We were talking a little bit about the patrons' lunch on the Mall for her 90th, which I chaired. We remember that day with great affection to celebrate her involvement in charitable activity." The NCVO was founded in 1919 as the National Council of Social Service, NCSS, before being renamed in 1980 as the NCVO, which has helped to establish independent charities such as Age UK, Citizens Advice and the Youth Hostels Association. The organization was first established using a gift from a voluntary sector pioneer who was killed in the First World War. Edward Birchall died aged just 32 during the Battle of the Somme and left a legacy of £1,000, equivalent to around £85,500 in 2018 according to the Bank of England's inflation calculator. He had been a leading figure in the Guilds of Help movement of the time, a forerunner to social services, and his gift was used to set up the NCSS. Currently, over 3,000 organizations list a member of the royal family as their patron or president. Every member of the royal family receives hundreds of requests each year from organizations asking for their support. Royal patronages add status to an organization, and visits and involvement from a royal patron can often bring much-needed publicity. In 2016, after the end of the year of 90th birthday, she passed 25 of these patronages to younger members of the royal families. The patronages included the Holocaust Memorial Day Trust, the Amateur Swimming Association as well as Rugby Football League. Buckingham said at the time that the Queen was following the example of the Duke of Edinburgh.